2017. I'm Tristan Perez. In Washington, an investigation into election meddling is getting serious. We've got details.
And I'm Jose Fernandez. At the T-Rex debate, your phones would explode. Your CSN news starts now.
Leo Club and FCCLA are joining forces next week to raise money for Red Nose Day on Thursday, May 25th, to help children in need. NHS can do its share to help end child poverty by joining in on the fun and purchasing our bake sale items on the cafeteria in room 110. There will be themes for each day up to Thursday's Red Nose Day.
Students and staff can show their spirit by giving dress to Retro's 80 Mondays the 22nd, donning their superhero outfits Tuesday the 23rd, getting into Disney characters on Wednesday the 24th, and wearing Red Nose on Thursday the 25th. Red Nose Day was started by Comic Relief Inc. and helps provide meals and medical assistance and safe places to live for children in need. Red Noses can be purchased at your local Walgreens, or you can have a Red Nose painted by purchasing big items. Contributions will be donated to the Red Nose Day USA page to be matched by Bill Gates Foundation.
Spirit of the Nampa High Bulldogs. The 2017-18 Cheer Squad will be holding tryouts May 22nd, 23rd, and 24th from 5:30 to 7:30 p.m. in Main Gym. Tryouts are open to any student at Nampa High School. The mandatory parent meeting is May 16th at 7:30 p.m. in Nampa High Cafeteria.
Color Guard and those interested in Color Guard. There will be a Color Guard parade practice for Parade of America at 2:45 on May 18th and 19th in the band room. Also, Color Guard tryouts will be May 24th to the 26th from 3 to 5 p.m. in the cafeteria.
Hey, basketball fans. It's time for the annual 3-on-3 basketball tournament fundraiser. Help support the Sports Med Club and sign up this week. $5 to play. Teams of three or four must be co-ed. Pick up a release waiver and sign up your team with Opal in the athletic training room after school until Friday. Tournament will take place in the main gym on Friday, May 26th at 5 p.m. Admission is $3. Staff, we're still looking for participants for the staff bank bracket. Email Opal if you're interested.
If you are a transferring senior, then you need to turn in your device, case, and charger after you complete your last final at Columbia. If you do not return your device, it could have an effect on your opportunity to walk at graduation. As soon as you no longer need it, turn it in. We'll be right back after this.
Attention all students who drive to school. Recently, there have been many hit and runs in the student parking lots at all three schools. It's a felony when you hit someone's car and drive off, and you will be cited and reported to the cops, and your driving privileges may be taken away. If both vehicles are occupied, then exchange contact information, license plate numbers, driver's license numbers, and insurance information. If your vehicle is the only occupied one, then leave your contact information along with insurance information and driver's license number and plate on the windshield. This message is brought to you by the Nampa Police Department.
Today's weather is brought to you by Dr. Kim Keller. Your smile is your first impression. Make it go and visit Dr. Keller today. Today we're going to have a high of 65 and a low of 43, and tomorrow is going to be a high of 71 and a low of 45. It's going to be a little cloudy, but it's going to be a nice sunny weekend for the rest of the days. Back to you, Fernandez.
Thank you, Perez. The Justice Department appointed Robert S. Mueller III, a former FBI director, as a special counselor on Wednesday to oversee the investigation into ties between President Trump's campaign and the Russian officials. The decision by the Deputy Attorney General, Rod J. Rosenstein, came after a cascade of developments in recent days, including the abrupt dismissal of the FBI Director James B. Comey and the subsequent disclosure President Trump may have asked Comey to drop the investigation with former National Advisor Michael T. Flynn.
Florida State, everybody knows that the Tyrannosaurus Rex, the Mighty King of the Dinosaurs, was a fearsome carnivore, but new discovery shows that this bite was truly horrific. A new study published in Scientific Reports, researchers from Florida State University revealed the true power of a T-Rex bite, including its ability to make bones disintegrate. Using computer models based on the muscular structure of modern-day crocodiles and their kin, researchers applied virtual muscles to bone. Once the models were complete, they observed how the T-Rex would have bitten down on prey, discovering just how powerful the animal's jaws really were. According to the data, a living T-Rex would have had roughly 8,000 pounds of buying force at its disposal. However, taking into account the arrangement and the shape of its long, cone-shaped teeth, the scientists were able to calculate how much force each tooth would apply, which measured an amazing 431,000 pounds of pressure per square inch.
The SAT word of the day is canon, which means a collection of books determined to be authoritative or law, a law or rule. You could use it this way. The rabbis of the early second century set out a biblical canon. As a group, they determined which books would be included in the Bible and which wouldn't.
Thanks for watching. Remember, if the news breaks,
we'll fix it.